Creating engaging and effective video animations for your brand or business can be easier than you think, especially with some of the more accessible and easy to use tools that we have available, like Canva. Now, while it might seem a little tricky to get a handle on the animation tools at first, you can easily craft some pretty impressive videos by kind of layering a series of simple individual animations. So today I'm going to walk you through how to create a stylish animated video to highlight the features of your product or your offer, all just by following a simple step-by-step process that builds up to a really effective result. And we're going to do it all just using Canva. We're just going to start with a simple horizontal video file in Canva. And here I've just changed the background color to be one of the brand colors from my primary palette, which I have in my brand kit in Canva. The next slide is just a slide where we're going to gather our elements. Now, if you've seen any of my previous videos, you'll know that I sometimes do this when I'm working with many slides and different animations. I have a kind of working slide, which just means that I can put all the elements that I'm going to use in that design on that slide, so it's easy for me to access them and copy and paste them onto subsequent slides, rather than having to go back to any of the Canva libraries or my own files to import them or to find them every time I need them. And here I've just brought in some simple elements and combined them into more complex elements. So for example, here I have a simple circle graphic with an outline, and I found this little plus icon, and I've combined them and grouped them into this element down here, which I can then animate and treat as one individual element. The same goes for these boxes, which are going to be used to describe what the feature is of our product. They are just made up of a couple of text boxes, a simple box with rounded corners, and I searched for a rectangle shadow in the Canva Elements library, and I've just put that behind the box. Then I've just grouped them, and again, this can be treated as a single element. I also looked in the Canva image library for a product, and we're going to use these headphones as our product today. I also know I wanted to use a couple of animated elements, so I found these here that I'm going to use later on in the video. In the first page or scene of this video, we're just going to add in some branding and the first image of the product. I asked ChatGPT to come up with an idea for a name of a headphone brand, and the one that we're going to use is called Pulse Fidelity. So I'm just going to add a text box to this slide, type in the words Pulse Fidelity, and then I'm going to format this text so that it fills the slide. I'm using a Canva font called a Grandier Grand, and I'm going to use the black version of that, and just adjust this until it fits the way that I want it to fit across the page. I'm also going to adjust the transparency so that we can still see it, but that it doesn't dominate the slide quite so much. And that's because we're going to put the product image over this text. I'm going to go to my working slide and just copy that product image and paste it onto our first slide. And then I'm going to enlarge that so that it takes up the majority of the space. Next, I'm going to add another text box and add in the name of the headphones. And I've called them the Pulse 1.0 headphones. And then again, I'm just going to format this so that it fits and looks the way I want it to look. I want it to stand out a little bit, so I'm going to go to Effects and I'm going to choose Shadow. I'm going to choose the shadow color to be black. And then I'm going to give it a bit more of a blur and just play around with these settings until I'm happy that it stands out from the background. The next page or scene is actually going to be a default that we're going to use many times throughout this design. I'm going to copy the product image and paste it onto this next slide. And this is going to be the default slide because we're going to keep coming back to it as we showcase the features. I'm going to go back to my working slide and select the group of that icon that I created, and then go back to our product image, and I'm going to paste that group, resize it, and then I'm going to place them where the features are that I'm going to showcase. I'm going to copy and paste this entire slide, and then I'm going to add in a feature box. Again, going back to my working slide, I'm going to copy that whole group that I created, and I'm going to paste it in. Then I'm just going to move it so that the corner just crosses with one of those little signpost icons that I had. I'm going to click on the position tab at the top here, and I'm going to move it behind the icons so that it just peeks out from behind them. Then I'm going to duplicate our default slide that I just created with the four little icons, and I'm going to also select the slide that has a feature box, and I'm going to copy and paste those three times. If I just make sure I'm on the zoom thumbnail setting and I zoom out, you can see that I now have those slides all pasted in here. Then I'm going to go to our second feature slide, and I'm going to move that features box so that it appears just peeking out from one of the other icons. I'm going to do that again for the remaining two so that we have four different features highlighted. Now, if I go back to the beginning, although we don't have any animations in here yet, if I just click and drag the playhead, you'll see we have those icons appearing. Then the feature box appears. Then we return to that default slide. Then the next feature box appears, and that happens for the remaining two feature boxes. Now I'm just going to go through and change the text in those feature boxes to highlight the four different features. Once I've done that, we then want our final slide in this animation, and it's actually going to be based on our first slide. So I'm just going to copy that slide, paste it, and move it to the end. For this final slide, in the background, I'm going to want a call to action. So instead of the brand name there, I'm going to just type in "Get yours now," and then reposition that so that it fits better. I'm also going to make sure that the product scales down a little to give us a bit more room underneath it. And underneath is where we're going to put the domain name or URL so that people can find it easily. I'm going to adjust the spacing and take the size down of this text and then put in the domain name. And to highlight that more, I'm going to add a shape behind the domain name. So I'm just going to go to the elements and scroll down to shapes, see all, and I'm going to choose this pill shape here. Click on that and add it, and then close the library. Now I'm just going to drag that along and reposition it so that it's behind the text and it gives us a good frame to work with. I'm also going to put a border around that and make it white so that it really stands out from the background and people can immediately see where to get their version of these headphones. So now we essentially have the basics for our entire video, but we have yet to add animation and any of the transitions in. For most of these slides, we're going to use our old favorite match and move. So I'm just going to click between one of them, add transition, and I'm going to choose match and move, and I'm going to apply that between all pages. So now match and move appears for all of these slides, and you can see just without anything else, it adds in a really nice kind of slick and smooth animation. But between the first and second slides, I just want a simple fade. So I'm going to click on that transition and just change it to dissolve. So it moves really nicely from our first page to our second page with just a simple fade. Next, we're going to add in some individual animations. On the first slide, for our big block of text at the back, I'm going to go to animate and I'm going to scroll down to the writing animations and choose merge. And I'm going to slow that down a little. Then I'm going to click on the product and I'm going to use the succession animation, which I'm also going to slow down a little. And then for the product name, I'm going to just choose a simple blur effect for that to come in. Next thing I want to do is to adjust timings of these. So with any of them selected, I'll click on the three dots and choose show timing. And you can see in the timeline they appear when we click on them. So first we want that text to come in that says the brand name, Pulse Fidelity. Next we want the product to come in. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to click and drag from the left hand side so that it only appears once the words Pulse Fidelity have come in. And then lastly I want the headphone name, so I'm going to click on that box and then click and drag that from the left hand side, and you'll see just once the product appears and has stopped moving, that's where the product name is going to come in. So if I just drag the playhead to the left and click play, you'll see the words come in, then the product and the product name. And then we fade to the next slide. On the next slide, I just want these individual little icons to pop in just one at a time. So I'm going to do that by using my shift key and clicking on each of them so that they are all selected. Then I'm going to click on animate and I'm going to choose pop. And that will allow them to pop in individually as we move to that slide. Next, we want our feature pages to be formatted with some animations. So what we're going to do here is we're going to increase the size of the icon so that it draws attention to that feature. And we're going to turn the icon, rotate it 90 degrees. Now, if I go back and drag playhead to the previous slide, the match and move animation has already been set because of that transition. And so what will happen is that icon will really smoothly enlarge and rotate which will draw attention to that feature. The feature box I want to just pop in, so I'm going to choose animate and pop. But I only want it to appear once the icon has started to enlarge and rotate. So I'm going to click and drag it from the left, and we'll just see once that icon has almost completed its rotation is where the feature box will start. So I'm going to drag my playhead back and just check how that looks. As we transition, it enlarges and the box pops up. And then you'll see we return to the default slide. And that's why we have one of those between each of these, so that we can return to that neutral kind of state. Now I'm just going to repeat that exact same animation for the second, third, and fourth feature boxes and the icons. For our final slide, we're just going to change the animations a little, so we're still going to have the text coming in first. This product image, we're actually going to just leave without an animation, because it will resize using the match and move transition. And the words pulsefidelity.com with the domain, we're just going to change the animation to be a typewriter animation, so that that comes in letter by letter and draws attention to it. We also want the box behind it to animate in, so I'm going to choose animate and blur, and then what I'm going to do is just make sure that the text itself only starts coming in once that box has appeared. So just click and drag the playhead so we can preview it, and you'll see once the box appears is when the typewriter text should appear. Next we're going to do is just change the timing of the slides. So for the feature slides, the 4.5 seconds, which it's used as a default here, works really well. But for the default slides in between, we only need those on for a second or so, so I'm going to take them down to about 1.5 seconds, and that I'm going to do for each of those that appears between the feature slides. And I'm going to extend our last slide because we want to have the call to action on for longer to encourage people to go and find the product. So before we add our finishing final touches, if you're enjoying this video and you want to learn more about how to use Canva like a professional, then if you head to the link on the screen right now or in the description below the video, you can sign up for my weekly design digest called Meaningful Creations. Every week I share new tutorials and resources, personal and business insights, and design inspiration. There's no hard sell or hustle, just authentic and honest resources and advice based on my real life experience. I would really love to have you be a part of that community and to help me ensure that the content I'm creating really supports you. Okay, now let's get back to the video. If I go back to the beginning of the video and just hit play now, you'll see we have the text coming in, the product and the name. Then we go back to that default slide where they pop in. Then we have a feature. We return again to the default slide. Then we have a feature, and that continues for the final two features. And each time the match and move transition has created that very smooth animation as those features pop in and out. Then we go to the final slide where we have our URL and our call to action. There are two final things that I would like to add. The first is to add some of these animated graphic elements. So I'm going to click on this little sound file and copy that. And on our final slide, I'm just going to paste that in, and I'm actually going to place it in two different places. One at the top on the left and one on the right. Then I'm going to use the position tab to make sure that they are behind the product, so that they appear to be coming from it. And I'm actually going to change the timing on these so that they only appear once the domain name has appeared, so that we don't detract from the domain name. I'm also going to use the other animated element here, and that just looks like it kind of indicates that there's sound coming from the earphones, so I'm going to put that into this final slide as well. Copy and paste it and rotate it so that we can have one on each side coming from the headphones themselves. And again, those I'm just going to bring in a little later once the domain name has appeared. Our final animated element is this little concentric circle, and that I'm going to use to highlight, again, the features that we have added in. So when the icon enlarges, I'm actually going to paste one of those animated circles in, and I'm going to put it over that icon. And I'm going to do that on each of these product feature pages, so that we draw attention to the feature that is being highlighted. And then the last thing that makes a huge difference would be to add some sound effects or some music to this. Now, obviously you can upload your own music or use music from Canva's library if you have access to those tracks. And you can just click and drag an audio track underneath the whole thing. But you can also search for some sound effects, like some subtle pops or whooshes that just add a little bit of something to the video. And it also creates a lot of engagement when you see it on social media because it draws your attention to it. So I'm just going to do that to complete my video. And once that's done, I'm just going to remove the two working slides from the front of the video, and our final product is ready. So that's it, folks. I hope that this has been helpful and has inspired you to experiment with combining simple animations and elements to make something magical. If you haven't already, please don't forget to join my newsletter and have a fabulous rest of your week.